Welcome back, FUD Nation. I'm Elio Trades, and today we're going to be going over all of the achievements that the blockchain industry has racked up over the past few weeks. Obviously, with all the market sliding and the hiccups with the price action, it's very easy to lose focus of all the achievements and the positive momentum that this industry has built. And so to shine a light on that, we're going to be going over what is a list, but not an exhaustive list, but a list indeed of very exciting projects that have been making headway and delivering upon their roadmap and their goals and moving their projects technology forward. So today we're going to be going over testnets, mainnets, and platforms that have been released or are planning to be released in the near future. Today's FUD TV episode is all about tech that's being delivered. So we're going to start off with testnets before moving on to mainnets and then full-on platform releases. The first testnet that we're going to go over pretty quickly is Tron. Many of you are probably familiar with Tron, but if you're not, it's a high-throughput dApp platform that has a millennial focus focused on video games and different sort of post-90s, as they would say, interests. They have amazing partnerships and a phenomenal CEO in Justin Sun, who's somewhat of a celebrity. Obviously, they've come under scrutiny in their history, and there's been quite a bit of criticism that their testnet really wasn't that overwhelming, as it does not support dApps or smart contracts, which is definitely what we're expecting from Tron, so we can't quite test the things we're expecting to come from Tron. So while this is a great testnet release, and Tron is a very exciting project, we definitely were hoping for probably a little bit more, and we'll be looking for that mainnet release out of Tron within the next few months to really see some of these projects that we've heard about, these partnerships that we've heard about come to life. The go live date for Tron's testnet was 3/31, March 31st. You'll see that as a repetitive theme as people were really waiting till the last day so they could say that they delivered upon their roadmap goals within Q1, the last day of it. The next testnet that just got delivered is from Zilliqa. Zilliqa is a high-throughput blockchain or a scaling blockchain that's based on the concept of sharding, where the network is divided down into subgroups and information is processed at the same time in parallel so that the blockchain doesn't have to wait, so that the blockchain doesn't have to go through its relatively slow process. As we know, Bitcoin and Ethereum only do a max of about 20 transactions per second. Zilliqa is already doing 2,000, and they say that in private sort of test conditions, they've done up to 4,000, but you know, the goal here is to really get this sharding mechanism to be able to deliver millions of transactions per second. So they're really looking to do tons and tons of transactions per second, and this is uniquely focused at scaling, and their live date went live on 3/31 as well. So this is yet another test net that's being delivered, a beta release, if you will, on its way to a full release of the technology. The next testnet that we're going to be talking about is Ontology. Now, we've covered it pretty extensively on this channel, so if you want to go check out a more extensive review, you can feel free to do so, but it is essentially a trust ecosystem that layers multi-chains, so many blockchains, and accesses them together, as obviously some blockchains in the more institutional world, the more serious part of the world, like banking and insurance and medical records, require privacy. They can't be sort of stored on a Neo or Ethereum or some open chain. So Ontology essentially works as a bridge between public and private chains. They're very much so focused on some specific institutions and segments of the economy, like government administration, legal, medical, insurance, identity. They list them all in their white paper, and we go over all of them in our video on Ontology if you really want to check it out. The whole point here is that this is a very interoperable project that is compliance focused. So whenever the laws sort of come in and the rules come into play and governments start really trying to clamp down and control what's going on in this cryptocurrency and blockchain space, Ontology could be a mechanism, or is looking like it's going to be a mechanism for that to happen. So yes, this is a little bit like Big Brother-ish, but it's also kind of like allowing this ecosystem to come above board and to have all the actors be recognized as good actors. So yin and yang on that. However, we do know that they are part of the on-chain and Neo ecosystem, which is a phenomenal place to be, as it's really one of the central hubs, or it's certainly the central hub for Chinese blockchain. It was started by the founders of AntShares, Neo, by Dahong Fei. They soon realized that Neo, formerly AntShares, could not serve the private economy and big businesses and certain other partners that wanted blockchain technology. So they created OnChain, which is sort of a private VC-backed company that creates all these different projects like Ontology, which has an amazing team and is designed to sort of work in synchronous with Neo to create the smart economy of the future. It's a very cool project that's been doing phenomenally well, even in this bear market. It doesn't seem to want to dip. and it went live on March 31st as well. The next testnet we're going to be talking about is High Performance Blockchain, or HPB. It's a high throughput blockchain, which is also focused on scaling, but they use a unique approach of hardware and software that are made to be integrated. So they have these circuits, these chips that are built to integrate directly with their blockchain and speed up the transactions to essentially scale the blockchain so it can go really, really fast by using the metal itself. It's got a chip accelerator engine. It's a pretty interesting project, it's very innovative, and it went live on 4/4/2018. And we just covered Nebulous in a very extensive What Is video, and if you're curious about it, you should really go watch that video. It's an amazing interoperable project that essentially is the Google for blockchain. It's a decentralized search framework that allows for other dApps to be built on top of it. We search and use anything across any blockchain, in theory. At the moment, it processes 1,000 transactions per second. It's got dApp support and smart contract support, and it allows for something called migration, so that dApps or smart contracts on other platforms like Ethereum could migrate over to Nebulous at no cost. It's a very innovative project and they're doing very well, and this is their mainnet, not their testnet. So now the building on Nebulous can truly begin. This platform is really set to grow now. It also went live on March 31st. Another mainnet went live on March 30th called Request Network. If you don't know about Request Network, it's a peer-to-peer cash system or payment system. The whole point here is they want to make this whole system very easy to send cash or payments through the crypto economy. So they run on the Ethereum blockchain and essentially allow for you to really easily send requests to any of your contacts, save those contacts, have it be more like a Venmo experience. It's a very streamlined, user-friendly experience, and it plugs right into your MetaMask or your Ledger, and they went live on March 30th. And Walton Chain also went live with their mainnet. If you don't know about Walton Chain, they're a logistics and supply chain management chain. Now, they produce IoT devices to track physical things across the supply chain and manage them on blockchain. They're located in China. They have had some PR nightmares of recent with a failed Twitter giveaway where it was revealed that someone within their very organization actually won the Twitter giveaway. So it sort of felt like they were inward dealing, or it really didn't feel good to the community. They also announced a partnership with Alibaba Cloud and then withdrew it, or we retracted it that day, and it sort of felt like it was just very weird. But the reality is that they didn't delete the Medium article, so we still know that they're going forward with a lot of their partnerships, which includes government partnerships and a partnership with an Alibaba Cloud company, a subsidiary of Alibaba, which is in reality a partnership with a subsidiary of Walton Chain, but it sort of all trickles up in the end. And the reality is that they're building smart cities, they're doing amazing things, they're even getting into smart oceans and crazy stuff. They allow for mining and staking, and they went live with their main chain on 3/31/18. So this is awesome. Walton Chain is a phenomenal project. You should definitely check them out, and yet another big delivery from a massive project in the space. Now, the first platform that we're going to cover that just went live is Genesis Vision, or GVT. This is an investment platform or an asset management platform, and they want to revolutionize the way investors and brokers and traders and managers all sort of work together. They allow you to trade on a wide variety of platforms, and they sort of allow you to invest in investors or traders or managers, as they say, and sort of essentially anybody can make their own token, take assets under management by way of allowing someone to buy your token, and then you trade, and then those investors can collect profits as well as you. Pretty interesting stuff, and yeah, it's just another investment platform. It's a very innovative one at that, and it kind of reminds me of Covesting and other different ones in the space, so we'll see how they do at creating a market for this. It's in demo mode right now, so none of the trades will be with real money, and it went live on 3/27, March 27/18, a little bit before the deadline this time. Now, this mainnet hasn't quite gone live yet, but it's projected for April at some point. If you don't know about Oyster Pearl and Oyster Shell, essentially this is a network for decentralized web and data processing. They allow for an implementation of their system with one line of code, which essentially allows for you to turn your website into a data processing hub, allowing for you to earn money from data processing and not from advertisements. Their whole idea here is to erase ads from the web. We couldn't support this mission anymore, and that's why we're very excited that they're moving ahead. They recently also announced that they're going to be airdropping their Shell token to all Oyster Pearl holders. So if you have Pearl, you're going to get airdropped some Shell. So that's very, very exciting. And I think that's supposed to happen with the mainnet launch. And finally, we have Dragon Chain, which is an extremely user-friendly enterprise blockchain solution aimed at sort of bringing blockchain to big companies, big enterprises. They're compliance-friendly. They do all the layers of the blockchain, making it super, super easy for companies, big companies to switch over and start using blockchain. There's rumors and speculation that they might be working with Starbucks. They were incubated within Disney. They were actually Disney's private blockchain before they were made a public project and sort of done in this fashion that most blockchains are done in. They have extreme flexibility for devs, and they act as really the bridge into the blockchain space. They also have a scalable serverless platform, which is powered by AWS. And their go live date is April 5th. That's today. There's a lot of excitement around the Dragon Chain project, and for good reason. It's because they might be bringing blockchain to really big companies right here in America. They're based in Seattle, right around tech giants. They definitely seem to have some really good reach because they're Disney connections. So they're definitely someone to be excited about, and them debuting their platform could mean that a lot of big companies start getting into blockchain really, really soon. We just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a peek into our minds and what we're seeing that's so exciting about this entire blockchain industry, how the tech is moving as fast as it's ever moved, despite the price action and the bearish trends in the market. And these projects are moving fast, delivering on their promises and hitting their milestones. So if you've been in the dumps a little bit about your portfolio, don't be, because there's excitement and there's movement happening every day. Even though it seems like blockchain might be suffering through an endless winter, the spring will come again, and it will be driven by amazing products and technologies delivering on their promises, like these right here. Thanks for watching this update about the progress in the blockchain industry. We hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, don't be afraid to smash that like button. It really helps us and YouTube know you enjoyed the content. Of course, if you're an investor or enthusiast in the space, subscribing to this channel is not a bad idea. We do multiple cryptocurrency videos on this channel each and every day. Please remember, we're not professional financial advisors, and this is just our opinions. We always encourage you to do your own research if you're going to invest. Once again, I'm Elio Trades. It's been an absolute pleasure having you with us today on FUD TV, and we'll catch you very soon on the next episode.